Good morning friends, today we are discussing the parallel operation of alternators. So what are the main advantages in the parallel connection? So main advantages are, first one is continuity of service. If suppose in place of one alternator we are going to connect the two alternators, if suppose any problem in this first alternator, okay, simply to connect the second alternator. So due to that one, continuous power supply or continuous of service. Next to maintenance and repair. If suppose you have any problem and any inspection, okay, so first one alternator is running and one more alternator is simply maintenance and repair. Next to third one is efficiency is increased. If suppose depends upon the load conditions, if suppose load is very less, so on that time one alternator is simply in the shutdown condition or floating condition, so only one alternator is connected on the full load condition, so on that condition efficiency is high. Next to greater security. So greater security means due to any dead short circuited and any high voltage, any problem will be developed in the one alternator, so simply we are going to the one more alternator, so on that time you got greater security. And physical size, so only one alternator we are using, so big size, that is a 1000 MV alternator, okay, that is a very big size. If suppose we are using two small size alternators, 500 MVA, so due to that one, physical size also advantages of this parallel operation of alternator. These are the main advantages. Next, what are the main conditions for parallel operation or synchronizing? So first condition is voltage. First check the voltage. So first we are taking the two alternators, one is the incoming machine and another is the running machine. Okay, first of all to check the voltage of the running machine and incoming machine by using voltmeter. Next to frequency, what is the formula of frequency? F is equal to Pn by 120. P means number of poles, N means speed. So second point is to check the frequency by using the frequency meter. So same to check the incoming machine of the alternator and running machine of the alternator. Next to third point is simply phase sequence of the incoming machine and running machine of the alternator. So these are the main three conditions to connect the parallel operation of alternators: phase sequence and voltage and frequency. Okay, so to connect the parallel operation, so we have three methods are there. Synchronization of alternators using three methods. First method is three dark lamp method. Second method is one dark and two lamps bright method. One dark and two lamps bright method. Next to third method is synchroscope method, by using synchroscope. To check the parallel operation. So these are the three methods. Okay, so in these three methods we are using the three dark lamp method generally we are using. So next to connection circuit, what is the main circuit of alternator? See the parallel operation of alternator, three phase alternator. See the circuit diagram. See the alternator 1 and alternator 2. So alternator 1 is a running machine, alternator 2 is a incoming machine. This is the incoming machine. So this incoming machine is parallelly connected to the alternator 1. So what are the main conditions? So before going to that, to check the parameters. So which one? First one is voltage parameter, and second one is frequency, and third one is the phase sequence. In the circuit diagram, L1 means it is the bulb. L1, L2, L3. So this is the switch. This is the synchronizing switch. So we have to satisfy the all conditions, then this the synchronizing switch will be closed. Okay, so before going to that, so what are the conditions, how to check the voltage and frequency and phase sequence. Okay, so the alternator 1, alternator 2, this is the load. If suppose load is only 400 MVA, okay, so in the alternator 1 is alternator 1 is the rating is 500 MVA, so this one also 500 MVA, but here load is only 400 MVA. So in this time we have only one alternator is sufficient to connect the or to meet the load. If suppose load is increases, load is increased to 800 MVA, so on that time, so we are going to we are taking the two alternators are connected in parallel. So first one is 500 MVA and second one also 500 MVA, so simply to meet the load. Okay, so in this time, so parameters, first to check the voltage values. So here simply to connect the one voltmeter in the alternator 2 and the alternator 1 also. First to voltage, first check the incoming mission of voltage. So how to vary the voltage? Simply vary the field excitation. So in the alternator having two windings, stator winding and rotor winding. So we are simply varying the field excitation and to vary the voltage in this alternator 2, that is the incoming machine, and check the this voltage and this voltage alternator 1. So here you got V1, so here you got V2. Simply V1 is equal to V2, then no problem. If suppose V1 is not equal to V2, then some circulating currents are flowing in this alternator. Okay, then simply any winding will be damaged. So that's why compulsory maintain the V2 is equal to V1. Okay, this is the first condition. Next to frequency, by using frequency meter to check the alternator 2 side and alternator 1 side. Okay, simply varying the speeds of the prime mover. So here vary the frequency by using the by varying the speed of the prime mover. Next to check the alternator 2 frequency and alternator 1 frequency by using frequency meter. So here the F1 and F2 both are same, then no problem. Next condition is phase sequence. So how to check the phase sequence? Phase sequence meter give the phase sequence. So phase sequence meter having a 3 voids generally. So that 3 voids put in the R, Y, B terminals. So first check the alternator 2 phase sequence. So in that phase sequence meter, some rotation is there. So if suppose in alternator 2 is to connect the R phase and Y phase and B phase, these three voids are connected in the connected to the alternator 2, simply that phase sequence meter is the direction is clockwise direction, that is a alternator 2 phase sequence. Next to after that, check the alternator 1 side. So that phase sequence meter, 3 voids are connected in R phase and Y phase and B phase, then here also same clockwise, so both are same direction. So that's why alternator 1 and alternator 2 both are same phase sequence, alternator 1 and alternator 2. If suppose in the alternator 2, if suppose anti-clockwise direction, for example, on that time to change the any two phases, to interchange the any two phases, then you got the clockwise direction. Okay, this is the phase sequence changing. So finally you got the same voltage of incoming machine and running machine, and same frequency and same phase sequence. So alternator 2 is the incoming machine and alternator 1 is a simply running machine. So this is the load. Okay, so finally this voltage and frequencies and phase sequence also matching. So then observe the lamps L1, L2, L3. So simply these bulbs are glowing simultaneously dark and bright, then No problem. If suppose one bulb is dark, one bulb is dark and one bulb is bright, then on the time frequency is not matching simply. So simply vary the once again the frequency. Okay. Finally, L1, L2, L3, all brights are all lights are dark at the same time. All lights are bright at the same time. Okay, on that time all bulbs are dark. On that time, simply the synchronization switch simply close. Then this alternator is synchronized to the alternator one. So that is the synchronization method. So here most small explanation. If suppose all bulbs are bright position means what is the meaning? So in between R and R dash. So these are the two alternators, R and R dash. So in this position, current is flowing in the R and R dash. So 120 degrees is the phase shift. In the B dash and R dash and Y dash. Okay, if suppose phase angle is 120 degrees phase shift. So on the time all bulbs are bright position. All bulbs are bright position. If suppose all bulbs are in the same phase position, same phase. So on the time all bulbs in the dark position. So in the dark position only to close the synchronization switch. Okay. One more important point is there. So if the incoming of alternator 2 is properly connected, all the three lamps should become bright and dim together. If they bright and dim in sequence, it shows the incoming alternator 2 is not properly connected with the bus bars. So compulsory all bulbs are at the same time bright and dark. So on the time synchronization switch will be closed. So this is the this is the parallel operation of two alternators. Okay, so actually in the lab also one simple circuit diagram also there. So observe that one also. So this is the one more circuit diagram of the parallel operation of alternators. Okay, so this simply in the some machine labs, in the electrical machine lab. So this is the circuit diagram parallel operation of alternator. So here simply, so this is the incoming machine. This is the incoming machine means that is a bus bar supply. This is the bus bar supply. Okay. So complete diagram. Bus bar is synchronized to the alternator. So here alternator and bus bar both are how to synchronizing. Okay. So in the lab you know already. So this is the motor. So motor see, the motor is coupled with alternator having a two windings, stator winding and rotor winding. So this motor output is simply mechanical. So that mechanical output is given to the alternator input. Okay, so here DC supply is given. LAZ is the 3-point starter. This is the DC motor, armature winding and field winding. This is the R1 rear starts. Then this is the stator winding RYB. This is the field winding. So here R2 and R3, these are the to applying the acceleration to the alternator. So we are using the R2 and R3 rear starts simply. Okay, next in the stator side, so this is the one wattmeter. So here also one more wattmeter is there. So here ammeter, this is the frequency meter, this is the voltmeter. So these 3 meters belong to the alternator. Next, so there are the lamps. So here also bulbs, here also bulbs, here also bulbs. So this side bus bar, this is the complete bus bar. This is the incoming supply of the bus bar. Bus bar voltage and bus bar frequency. Bus bar frequency and bus bar voltage. Then how to start the experiment or how to start the parallel operation to the bus bar to the alternator. So in this diagram, first simply switch on the DC motor by help of the starter. Okay, Next, after that, simply by wearing the R1 rheostat to set the speed. Then after that, so here supply. This is the bus bar supply. Switch on the bus bar supply. Then here R2 and R3, they are the two rheostats applying the excitation. R2 and R3. Then here you got some voltage here. So observe this voltage and this voltage. Bus bar voltage and alternator voltage, both are same or not. Observe here. If suppose not same, then apply the some excitation R2 and R3 by using R2 and R3 rheostats. Okay. Next to observe the frequency meters here. Just wearing these three rheostats, R1 and R2, R3 rheostats, observe the voltage and frequency values. Okay, frequency measured by using frequency meter. Next to one more thing is to check the phase sequence. Phase sequence means by using phase sequence meter. So here are the three weights R, Y, B. So phase sequence meter having three weights R, Y, B put in the bus bar side. So here simply check the phase sequence. Here you got the clockwise direction, clockwise. Then to check the in the alternate side. So here R, Y, B. So the phase sequence meter three weights are connected in the alternate side R, Y, B. So here also you got the clockwise. If suppose for example you got anti-clockwise direction, simply change the two phases, any two phases, then you got the clockwise direction here and here. Okay, that is a phase sequence. So finally you got voltage V1 is equal to V2 and frequency F1 is equal to F2 and phase sequence also same. So on that time observe the bulbs. So all bulbs are simultaneously bright and dark. Okay, so all bulbs here, these bulbs and these bulbs, all bulbs are simultaneously bright and dark. So in the dark portion only, so simply close the synchronization switch. In the dark portion only, simply close the synchronization switch. Okay, so at the same time you have to observe the in this experiment synchroscope also. Synchroscope, so this is the synchroscope. So here some small LEDs are there. So if suppose in the alternator is in the fast direction, this is the fast direction, here slow direction. So before going to the synchronization switch is closing, so here synchroscope also just observe that one. So in the middle side simply these are the LEDs are small brightness in the middle. So this one and lamps, all lamps are in the bright and dark portion. In the dark portion only simply close the synchronization switch. Okay, simply close the synchronization switch. Then finally this bus bar is synchronization to the alternator. Okay, so bus bar you are taking the one more alternator also, no problem. So this is the complete parallel operation of three phase alternators. Okay, thank you.